Users of Cinema 4D Release 19 Visualize and Studio Editions can now directly render stereospherical images for use in virtual reality and dome projections. And this is all accomplished through the spherical controls that have been added to the camera object. So with any camera that's already been positioned and animated, you can go into the spherical tab and simply check the enable box. Now you can see that by default, this renders a equirectangular lat-long image. This basically takes the full 360 degree view around the camera and maps it onto a plane. We could take this same projection and map it onto a C4D sky object or a sphere, and we'd essentially have an HDR sky. This is the most popular mapping type for 360 degree videos because it fits into our standard 16:9 frame aspects pretty well. The problem is that it introduces a bit of distortion, especially at the poles, and cubic mapping can help to minimize that distortion. So Cinema 4D also supports a number of different cube mapping formats. The string format maps all of the faces of the cube in a horizontal line. And this, as well as the equirectangular format, are supported in the standard and physical render, as well as ProRender. Now, if you're using the standard or physical render, there's a couple of additional mapping types you can use, including the cross mapping type that's used by Metal Skybox Studio and other compositing applications. And also the 3x2 cube map that's used internally by Facebook for all of their 360 degree videos. This format's great because it efficiently maps all of the faces of the cube into a fairly usable aspect ratio. Now, of course, when you're rendering VR images, you need to do that in stereo, and the stereoscopic tab automatically updates when spherical is active to provide you with special options for spherical rendering. You can render proper 360 degree stereo in either parallel or toe-in mode, and you can lay out the images either in top-bottom or side-by-side format, or simply render the left or the right eye. Let's go ahead and switch back into lat-long mode so that you can see the typical output that you would use for YouTube VR. Now, here in the stereo settings, you can set the eye separation, which would typically be 6.5 centimeters, but I've scaled it here based on the scale of my scene. You can also set the eye to neck distance. You also have the option to enable pole smoothing, which minimizes distortion at the top and the bottom of the image that are created by the stereo offset of the cameras. And you have the typical options here with pole smoothing to use linear or exponential algorithms. And of course, you can set the angle at which that smoothing begins to occur, as well as the exponent that's used to determine the curve of that smoothing. Now we also have the option in the spherical tab to limit the range of the render. This essentially gives you the ability to do a render region on specific latitude and longitude. So here we're limiting to just the front 180 degrees, as well as the 60 degrees in the center of latitude and longitude. But you can of course adjust this however you'd like to render a specific region of the frame. Now, when you use the fit frame option, it's going to take that region that you're rendering and scale it to the full image size. So you can easily render something like a 270 degree or 180 degree video. To help you dial in these ranges, the spherical camera has an FOV helper. And this is something that you won't see with the interactive render region active, and you also won't see when you're looking through the spherical camera. So we'll jump out into the editor camera, and you can see this representation here in the editor. This is what would normally appear as a camera object that shows the field of view of the camera. But when the spherical camera is active, it appears as a spherical representation of the area that will be rendered. So you can see that as we adjust the longitude as well as the latitude, it will actually show us what portion of the scene will be rendered with those settings. Now, if you're simply rendering a basic dome projection, you can change this FOV helper to a dome. And in that case, it simplifies these settings so that you only have to worry about the latitude and you'll see a representation of the dome itself. So that's a quick overview of some of the options that are available in the new spherical camera in Cinema 4D Release 19. Now, I've been showing you all of this with the physical renderer, but I also want to mention that the standard renderer has had a great speed enhancement in Cinema 4D Release 19, specifically in scenes that have a lot of reflection and transparency. And in fact, this particular scene renders about 2 times faster in the standard renderer with Release 19 than it did in Release 18. And of course, there's lots of enhancements, big and small, in Cinema 4D Release 19. So make sure to view all of our videos here on Cineversity, as well as the quick tips and reference videos that will be coming in the next few months, so that you can learn all of the power that's available to you in the latest edition of Cinema 4D.